Stand well. The Towton Cup field is set and ready. And the gates have gone back. They're off and racing. And Black Shadow and also Trap for Fools from the inside. They were the first to go. Trap for Fools, though, will go through and lead Black Shadow. Maragino's going to sit right outside of them, though, and he's going to take Trap for Fools on from the outside gate. Juicing Carrots is getting across there post-haste, just in front of Bad Wolf, settling down then. Bella's Idol and Dig Deep. Behind those, Taxigano. One off the fence early from Divine Shadow. Tell him we're coming three wide at Beckett's gate. Paddy Shadows back there, so's Pure Devotion, third from last, and dropping out to the back of the field, Stafford's Lad at the crossing at the 1600. Trap for Fools held the front, led Maricino. Black Shadow down on the inside, box seating early. Juicing Carrots has got across you. There's a good ride too from an outside gate. One off the fence at the 1400. On the rails, Bella's Idol, three quarters to a length away. Bad Wolf a length and a half away. Then came Divine Shadow, then Dig Deep. The pace going on, they're rolling strongly over into the back straight here in the Towton Cup. Pure Devotion's back in the second half in company with Taxigano. White on the course, Tell Him We're Coming, followed by Paddy Shadow, and Stafford's Lad is last of all and getting a good look at the field. The best part of a dozen lengths from the pacemaker, Trap for Fools, as they go down the riverside of the course. It's Trapper in front. Trap for Fools a length and a half to Maricino. Almost two lengths away then, Black Shadow getting a great run throughout though, followed by Juicing Carrots, who's on the outside of Bella's Idol. They're a length and a half clear from Bad Wolf, and then Divine Shadow. Dig Deep is back there. Tell Him We're Coming, Pure Devotion, the last trio, Stafford's Lad. He pulls out from last to try and make headway, and he's off and around the outside from Taxigano. Paddy Shadow, they're bunching up now. Maricino comes at Trap for Fools, and now on the outside, Black Shadow looms up to them to make a line of three. Two clear of Bad Wolf, Bella's Idol. Juicing Carrots calling it a day. Into the straight though, and Black Shadow hit the front from Maricino. They went to the 250. Black Shadow kicked away from Maricino. Pure Devotion behind them, starting to work its way through. Black Shadow with 100 left to go, though, nicely clear in the Towton Cup. Bella's Idol running on down the outside, Stafford's Lad, but Black Shadow wins it. Black Shadow won from either Bella's Idol or Stafford's Lad. G. Paddy Shadow from the back of the field, a big run. Then Pure Devotion, Tell Him We're Coming, and Bad Wolf, followed home by Maricino. Then Dig Deep, Trap for Fools weakened out of contention. Back there, Taxigano, Divine Shadow and Juicing Carrots amongst the last to salute the judge. Black Shadow, ridden to victory by Jason Brown, wins the feature event of the day. Jason winning the race for the first time since 2005. Last successful on the Sharon Miller train, Miss Copycat. But for his longtime mate, Jim Taylor, it's Black Shadow who got the most ideal of runs. The pace was on, and he goes back-to-back in the 7 days. Black Shadow 11 first for Jim Taylor. Jason Brown in the saddle, defeating 10, Bella's Idol, Brad Parnham, and third, number 14, Stafford's Lad, from last in running around the outside of the field. Another very good run, Chris Parnham aboard. Fourth is number six. And there's a nice run as well, Paddy Shadow getting through the field, but they did run it strongly. 2:16.30, and Trap for Fools certainly had the foot on the accelerator most of the way. Maricino, he buckled to that pressure. Black Shadow, the one that was sitting pretty, and won by a length and three quarters. A short half head, second and third, 36.30, the last 600. Great win for owner Rick Hart as well. And Trade Fair, the seven-year-old, with his 10th win from 46. Out of Black Vision, Jim Taylor prepares. Jason Brown in the saddle, of course, and racks up another Towton Cup victory. Second home, Bella's Idol, continuing to hold form. The Vital Equine 8-year-old, Summer Dixon, really doing a grand job with this gelding. Brad Parnham aboard for F. Mueller, MD, and Mrs. R.M. Fortune. And 14, Stafford's Lad, by demerit from Crash Hot. For Richard Bennett, J.B. Bennett, B. Cox, the Netties on Tour Syndicate, A. Vallis, S. Henry, and also S. Went. Trained by Dan Morton, Chris Parnham there, the rider. It's 11-10, 14-6, a length and three quarters, a short half head after the running of the Towton Cup. The last event, the Bellis Racing Stables Handicap, 13 off we go, is the scratching in the last event of the day. And A great moment for the Taylor family downstairs. Celebrating this Towton Cup victory today is our own Britt Taylor, and with her dad, Jim.
Indeed, a great victory by Black Shadow there. 7 days ago he won. He comes here 7 days later, wins again. Dad, did you have any reservations about going here today on the seven-day backup? Or as he is a horse that we know loves a backup.
No, not at all, Brittany. It was a shame we had to run in this company before we get to the Perth Cup, you know, burning the points. But if the handicapper does the right thing, I know he's supposed to go up to 94, but if you take the top three out, it should have been about an 84 plus. So hopefully he's not too severe and he rates him off that.
It'd be nice to see him get his opportunity in a Perth Cup. What about the ride today from Jason? Clearly there was a tactic there to find the back of Maricino, and that's the back he wanted. How did you see it unfold?
I spoke to Jason after the acceptors and Jason said straight away, we're going to follow Maricino all the way. And as you know, Jason, 11 out of 10, just did what he said he was going to do.
That's exactly how it unfolded. Congratulations on the win.
Thanks, Brittany.
There is Jim Taylor after the victory of Black Shadow twice in the week after winning just 7 days ago, and he does it again today, taking out his first feature event, the Towton Cup. It's great to see for a horse that took a long time as a youngster to hit his straps, and is a horse that when he finds form, he really does hold it. And if you could only wish for horses to pull up out of races like he does, because you never really know that he's gone around, and that was the case all week today. Jason Brown is catching up with Michael Heaton.
Yes, I've got him here. We had a lovely run in transit there, Brownie. Looked like you had a lap full of horse turning for home as well.
Yeah, you know, he was out from a lovely draw, just able to get a nice soft run in behind those 2 litres. And when I was able to peel off the three deep line coming to the 600, I was always going to be pretty hard to beat from there.
He didn't just win, he put paid to them over the final furlong, so he looks like he was going to eat up that 2400 of a Perth Cup.
Well, it looks that way. He's going to get in with a good weight, and the horse is just training. Jimmy's just got the horse running through walls at the moment, so it's he's onward and upward.
You rode Nerf Bosk last week, last start, I should say. That's, of course, last season's Perth Cup winner. How can you compare the two heading towards the Cup?
Oh, it's hard to really line them up at this stage. You know, this horse is going to get in on the minimum. Nerf Bosk is probably going to get in on the top weight this year, so I'm sure we'll both be there in the finish.
Well done. Shaping up to be a great race. Good luck.
Cheers. Thank you.
There's Jason Brown, combines with Jim Taylor, and Black Shadow takes out the GA Towton Cup. You got me begging.